Hey everybody, so today we are looking at part of a music theory book, and I've marked it up so that we can read it more effectively. So we're looking at the section on style, and the first point is dynamics. So as you'll see in yellow, I've underlined the definition. This book makes it super easy to find important keywords because it puts them in bold a lot, or it italicizes them. And after that, you'll see I've underlined here in purple and put a question mark. So while we're reading, we're going to want to ask, how do I apply this? We have the what, the definition here. Now, how? Here they give a little bit of an example, but you need to think about your instrument and how you'll use it. Okay, let's keep going. So bullet points here that we see, you'll want to look at those. It's probably something important. Now, here in red, I've circled something that is above this figure or chart. And sometimes, if you're trying to be quicker, you can skip reading that if you can look at the chart automatically and figure out what they're trying to tell you. But it's still there if you need a little bit more of a description. So, here it's pretty clear though. We have the symbols, we have the name, we have what it does, and then how to say it. So, when you're taking notes, you don't need to write how they write, sounding it out. Maybe you already know how to say it, so you could skip that part, or you have a different way to write it. Okay, let's keep going. So here we see these italicized words I've underlined in yellow again, more important definitions and more pronunciations that you can write how you'd like. Okay, something new that we haven't seen yet is another figure, but here they're showing us how to see it in the music. So you're going to want to look at this so that you can apply it to your real life. What am I going to do when I see this in a piece? And where is it going to be? Okay, let's keep going. Now it's a little bit more of the same. Back to definitions, which they make clear. So if you're skimming, they'll stand out to you. And again, I've made an arrow here at this figure. Okay, so now we're learning. It's not always written below the music, maybe it's written above. That's something to pay attention to. And let's finish it off here just by looking at one more example page. And it's more definitions talking about what is this, what is this. And again, you want to keep asking yourself how. Here they give an example of how to apply it to one instrument. Now think about how you can apply it to yours. When we're asking ourselves these questions, how? Well, how can we answer them? You can ask your teacher, of course, or you can use your resources like YouTube to try to figure it out on your own before you confirm it with your teacher or a classmate. All right, thanks for listening.